Now, let's go and I propose we do one change. So instead of having four of these for play animation on input and just selecting all of these two, I think we can just, crunch all of them together. We can still keep this. This is not going to be really an issue. But let's go and create a new condition. And that new condition will be monitor attack input. Okay, open it up. And let's go and do clean this up. Oops. Add the namespace. And this will be, yeah, this is a condition. Condition, public, override, check condition. Again, let's do return value, return value. And let's just check one by one if state.rb return value will be true, if state.lb return value should be true again. And let's do it like this. And we might not need a return value in reality. So let's just say return true, return false. Let's delete this above. State.lt and state.rt. Okay, and this goes with the order you're pressing. So if you're pressing all four buttons together, it's going to take only the right bumper first. Okay, awesome. So, however, this does need to call a new, it does need to call an animation. So let's go and encapsulate this further. We can just create a new function inside over here. As you can see, most of this we don't need anymore. Okay, so I think on the next video we're probably going to delete most of this. So let's go over here and I'm going to create a new void play animation on. Or play attack animation. Let's see. Play attack animation. We only need to pass something over here, and I propose we get this enum from out of here, place it in here, and say input button B. Then we're going to do switch B. For all of this, we're going to create a function that goes and create and takes basically when we bring back the weapon actions, it's going to go and take back the, yeah, it's going to look what weapon you have on the right hand, and if you have a weapon on the right hand, it's going to give you the right bumper or the left bumper if you have a weapon on the left hand, and so on and so on. Because we don't have any of this right now, however, I'm just going to go. This needs to be state manager dot input button now, so we don't get the error. Okay, awesome. I'm just going to take this. Let's go back to state manager and break it over here. Okay, so let's take this and put this on. Yeah, doesn't need to be state anymore. Just the animation. The target bool is basically now can be is interacting. Let's hard code it for now. We're going to change it later. Crossfade. And let's say right trigger, oh it's attack 2. I'm just assigning them randomly right now. We're going to change it later. And I don't think we have a 4, so let's just leave it at 2. Okay, so play attack animation, then on monitor attack input, we're simply going to be saying state.play attack animation input button RB. And then we have LB, RT, LT. Awesome. Minimize. So, without really doing, actually, we need to add the create asset menu. Create asset menu. Menu name. Conditions. Monitor attack input, and as a plus we can also say on enable description equals monitors attack inputs, monitor attack inputs. So let's go and create a new condition now. Conditions, and let's go monitor attack input. I'm just going to take this and drop it in here. And that's basically, we change the functionality just like that. Let's bring this state manager out of view. We don't need it. Okay, and I'm playing different animations. And when we bring back the functionality with the different weapons, and different hands, then we're going to fix that as well. Awesome. So let's keep this short. As always, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, share with your friends. And if you like to see more, and if you like to see more videos, more series, more cool stuff like this, then consider supporting me on Patreon so I can keep making more videos. I'll see you on the next one.